sleeping more during the weekends could help you live longer. Working Monday to Friday from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m., dealing with a household full of kids that need to be driven to soccer practice and piano lessons, there is not much time for rest. So what do you look forward to? The weekend, of course, because it's the one time where you can get more sleep. We know that sufficient sleep is essential for living a long and healthy life, but now a recent study suggests that sleeping more on the weekends can help you live longer. Want to know more about that study and more facts that might be pretty uplifting? Stay tuned and we'll tell you. But first, before we begin this video, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more daily tips like this and turn on notifications so you never miss our new videos. All right, so let's talk about sleeping on the weekend first, and then we'll move on to some more uplifting facts. Professor and Director AKERSTEDT of the Stress Research Institute at Stockholm University and co-author of the study which is published in the Journal of Sleep Research told CNN that he was quite surprised by what researchers found when they focused on that block of time. Researchers set out to look at what happens when people have days off and decide to sleep more with those days off. To conduct the study, researchers looked at almost 44,000 people in Sweden, questioned them about their sleeping habits, and followed up with them 13 years later. They found that people who slept about 5 hours or less a night, which included weekends, increased their mortality rate compared to those who slept for 7 hours regularly. In addition, they found that participants who slept too much also had an increased mortality rate. Now, when researchers took a look at those who slept less during the week and more on the weekend, they found that the mortality rate was almost the same as those who slept for 7 hours regularly. This was only true for those who were under the age of 65. To add to the study, Michael Grander, director of the Sleep and Health Research Program and an assistant professor in the Department of Psychiatry in the University of Arizona College of Medicine, Tucson, told CNN, "Most people who are considered short sleepers are probably just shy of getting 7 hours. They might sleep 6 hours or slightly less. They are the ones who can compensate with longer rest on the weekends because there is not as much of a deficit. Sleep is something you need to replenish regularly if you don't want to hurt your health. It's a fundamental part of our biology, like breathing. It's a requirement." So you're probably wondering what this means for you. In the past, sleep experts have advised against trying to catch up on sleep on the weekends, reported Men's Health. Sleep scientist Matthew Walker spoke to NPR well before this study was conducted, and he explained to them that sleep is not like a bank. You can't accumulate debt and pay it off at a later point in time. If I were to deprive you of sleep an entire night, and then in a subsequent night, give you all the sleep you want, you never get back all that you've lost. But this recent study can now change that way of thinking. Authors from the study explain that the results imply that short sleep during the week is not a risk factor of mortality if you combine it with medium or long periods of sleeping on the weekend, reported Men's Health. According to a study published on PubMed, consuming caffeine up to 6 hours before bed can disrupt your sleep. For the study, participants were given 400 milligrams of caffeine, either at 0, 3, or 6 hours prior to their bedtime. Researchers used a sleep monitor to keep track of sleep disturbances. Results showed that a moderate dose of caffeine, 3 or 6 hours before bedtime, had significant sleep disturbances compared to the placebo group. Nighttime melatonin plays an essential role in the body's circadian rhythm. If you are unfamiliar with what that circadian rhythm is, in basic terms, it's the body's internal clock. With that said, a study was published on PubMed that wanted to see if ethanol, alcohol, has the ability to inhibit nocturnal melatonin. So researchers administered an ethanol dose of 0.34 grams per kilogram orally at 6 p.m., 8 p.m., and 10 p.m. for group A. For group B and C, the dose was increased to 0.52 grams per kilogram, but ethanol was substituted with water. Researchers found that when they increased the ethanol dose, it inhibited nocturnal melatonin by 20%, where the lower dose did not show any effect. So there you have it. Catch some more Z's on the weekend, and you might just have a longer life. So next time your mother, significant other, drill sergeant, or anyone else wants to wake you up on that glorious Saturday morning, just say, "Sorry, but if you want me to live until I'm 100, you'll let me sleep in." But we here at Bestie aren't done giving you good news. So here's a few more uplifting facts just to brighten your day. We know, we spoil you. Number one, sea otters. There is a lot to love about these fluffy little sea creatures. From their playfulness to their high-pitched squeaks of joy, there is no possible way these things could get any more adorable. Or could they? Apparently, the people at Board Panda tell us that sea otters hold hands when they sleep. As if that wasn't cute enough, they do it so that they don't drift apart. There's one really long word for that. What was it again? Oh yeah. Aww. Number two, youth. Aging is not only a scary thing, but it's also pretty lame too. Your back starts to hurt. If you're unlucky, you lose your hair. If you're really unlucky, you lose your memory, or maybe even something worse. So it's uplifting to think that for a moment, you were the youngest person on Earth. Think about it this way. When you were born, even if it was just for a second, you were a real celebrity. Out of all the people on planet Earth, you were the absolute youngest. So, even as you get old and look back on your life, take solace in knowing that you've got that accomplishment under your belt. Number three, stars. Speaking of celebrity, did you know that you were a star? Not just because you're beautiful, intelligent, and probably hilarious, Bestie viewer, but you're also made of stars. The scientists from space.com have graciously reported to us that we humans are, in fact, made of stardust. Not literally or in so many words, but let's break it down. The building blocks of life are carbon, hydrogen, nitrogen, oxygen, phosphorus, and sulfur. All these elements are what make up humans. And where do they come from? They are formed in the interior of none other than collapsing stars. So don't let anybody tell you you're not a star, because not only are you made of some of the most brilliant heavenly bodies, but you're also subscribed to Bestie, right? Number four, cows. It's hard to think of cows as adorable, mostly because steaks are so darn good. We don't want to identify with our food, but this next uplifting fact might just make you go vegan. There are a couple things about cows that we here at Bestie find downright heart-melting, such as they love to cuddle, enjoy music, and love to frolic. But we think that the most lovable thing about cows is the fact that they have best friends. Research done by Krista McLennan of Northampton University confirms this fact, and the way they did the study was amazing. They put a cow in a pen with two different cows, a preferred friend and a total stranger cow, and measured their heart rates. When they're with their best friend, the study found cows are less stressed and are much happier, which means not only are cows joyous when their best friend is around, but also they get panicky when they're gone. Makes you kind of feel guilty for eating that burger, huh? Number five, prison inmates. Whoa, what could possibly be uplifting about prison inmates? Well, hold on to your seats, because we've got an uplifting pairing made in heaven. Apparently, according to Catster, there is a prison in Washington with a very special program for their inmates. They give the inmates, who they think have a chance at rehabilitation, a foster cat that was supposed to be put down. So, essentially, a death row inmate. These two, despite their difference in species, tend to form a bond together, and the program seems to be working for the inmates. What do you think? Do you think prisoners should have the right to take care of cats? Let us know in the comment section below. Either way, you can't deny that giving the cats a second chance at life is pretty uplifting, whether it's with prisoners or not. And that's it. What did you think of our list? Did it turn your bad day into a good one? Did it in the very least make you smile? Why not share some uplifting facts or stories in the comments so we can all try to make each other smile today? Enjoyed this video? Hit the like button. And share with your friends. Also, subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.